Well, what's an ionic bond? An ionic bond is when you have a metal and a non-metal, as we just reviewed. Metals tend to lose electrons to become cations. That means that they have a positive charge. And non-metals tend to gain electrons to become negatively charged. That makes them an anion. So you have a cation and an anion. And the attraction between those opposite charges is what actually gives you the bond between metals and nonmetals. That opposite charge, opposites attract, is what gives you the bond itself. In ionic bonding, electrons are going to be completely transferred, and they're going to have atoms that are ch that have a positive charge and a negative charge. And then again, the attraction between the positive and negative is what gives you the actual bond itself with ionic bonding. All the elements on the periodic table, they have a pattern for how they're going to form ions, and it goes like this: 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus skip, 3 minus 2 minus 1 minus zip. So everybody in this first column is going to be a 1 plus, so everybody over here is going to lose one electron to become one positive. So hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, all these guys are going to be 1 pluses. In this column, everybody's going to be a 2 plus. This column, everybody will be 3 plus. This next column we're going to skip. We'll talk about it later. And then we have 3 minus in this column, 2 minus in that column, 1 minus in this column, zip. Okay, so we're going to have our positive ions over here. That's going to be our metals, are going to combine with our negative ions over here. That's going to be our nonmetals. And that's what gets us ionic bonding.